So, ikhwani, there is these ayat of the Quran that are mentioned in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran many ayat describing the na'im of al-Jannah. In the Jannah are a lot of na'ims, benefits, and things that people are going to get. The Shaykh made a series of dua. Everybody said, Ameen, Ameen. He asked Allah to put us all in Jannah. Asked Allah Azza wa Jalla to let us all partake and be admitted into the Jannah. From what Allah has mentioned in the Jannah, He mentioned, for an example, that there are rivers in Jannah. Many ayat tell you about the Anhar, the rivers of Jannah. Leban, there's that Leban in Jannah. There are the Huru'een, those women in Jannah, and many other things, many other things. And although all of these things are in Jannah that the Quran told us about, in an authentic hadith, the Prophet says, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, in the Jannah is what no eyes have ever seen, and no ears have ever heard, and it has never been contemplated in the heart of any human being. The Sheikh said he wanted to make a point, and the point here is, here it is, Allah has mentioned in Jannah, this is in Jannah, that's in Jannah, that's, and all of those things are mentioned in the Quran. And then the Prophet comes and he says, in the Jannah is what no eyes have ever seen, never heard, and no human being ever contemplated it. Which goes to show that what Allah created in Jannah is different from what the people know of these things, what they see here. They know about Lebanon here, they know about the rivers here. It's in the mind of people what a river is, what Lebanon is. It's in the mind. What a Hurain. We got an idea of that. But in Jannah, the reality of it, you don't know. So here we have in the Quran things being established that people can understand. But the Prophet saying that no mind has ever conceived it. So that goes to show, as it relates to Allah's creation, the makhluqat, the things that are in Jannah, people don't know what it's really like. It's not like what you have here. And this is with the things that He's created. Question now is, what do you think it is with Allah Himself? What do you think the reality is with Allah? So when Allah Ta'ala mentioned in that ayat, Laysa kamithli shay, nothing is like Allah, nothing is like unto Him, then it becomes an issue that becomes clear for the Muslim to understand. As it relates to Allah's names and attributes, you shouldn't make any comparison. You shouldn't misunderstand. He said, in addition to that, the statement of Abdullah ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased with him. And the statement of Abdullah ibn Abbas, it emphasizes and supports what was just mentioned. And that is, Ibn Abbas said, there is nothing that is in the Jannah that you find here in the earth, except it has the same name. That's it. So what is in Jannah? The trees, the Lebanon, whatever, those things. Ibn Abbas said, the name that you know is there, but the reality of it is not the same. So the Sheikh went on to say, and wanted to mention, that all of this goes to show, as it relates to Allah Azza wa Jal, that nothing is like unto Allah, even if the name itself has that thing connected to it, the reality is different.